What do pigeons have to do with pitch sequences? How does the Fibonacci sequence sound? What is the meaning of life? Where can I find the best tacos in town? These are some of life's biggest questions, and I have decided to seek the answers using modular synthesis. Come along with me. Welcome to Phazerville. In today's episode of Stolen Ornaments, I'm going to be talking a little bit about pigeons, as well as a bunch of trigger sequencers that I've recently conjured up. Let's get right into it. Yo, I look like hot garbage. Look what we got here. This display that you see right here is streaming over USB from this Ornament Crime module here. And look, we got some new stuff. Pigeons is a pitch sequence generator based on Fibonacci sequence type math, where you add two numbers and take the modulus. This DivSeq is a sequencer of clock dividers, two separate channels. There's this PolyDiv as well, which mimics the Subharmonicon. So many cool things. We've got different screensavers. Stars. Pew! Look at the stars. And we've got zaps. Zip, 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 zipping around. All right, enough of that nonsense. I was going to explain exactly what is Pigeons. So this is an original applet that I wrote, but I did steal the idea from Mark Evanstein on YouTube. I'll link the original video where he explains it much better than I could. I stole the idea from his Fibonacci music box.
There's a principle in math called the pigeonhole principle, which essentially states that if you've got a finite number of pigeonholes and a larger or even infinite number of pigeons, at some point you're going to end up with more than one pigeon in the same hole.
The basic idea is that one number is added to the next number divided by a set modulus, and then you keep the remainder.
And because the modulo operator is limiting us to the digits 0 through 9, there are now only 100 possible pairs of numbers. 100 pigeonholes.
There are two numbers that represent pitches. You can select a scale, and the numbers represent notes in the scale. And every time it is clocked, the two numbers are added, and the remainder of the modulus division is taken. And the pigeon there is singing a note, and it alternates every time. There are two separate channels, two independent pigeons, each with their own clock input. The CV will actually change the modulo while it's running, and then the outputs are pitch CV. Pretty simple concept, and you get melodies. And the idea is you'll end up with looping sequences depending on the modulo number and the starting coordinates, the initial seed numbers.
But since our pattern goes on forever, we have an infinite supply of these pairs of numbers, an infinite number of pigeons. This means that eventually we must return a second time to the same pair of numbers.
You can play with Mark's implementation of this right in your browser. I've basically implemented the same thing as an applet on the Ornament and Crime. 11 is kind of interesting. 6-10, wow, that's a short sequence. See, so it's like 6-10, something, 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 5-10, 5-3, it's doing the same few. So modulo 11, but if this was like a little different, is it repeating? 7-5, yep, it's still repeating. So 11 is kind of a shorter, will give you shorter melody sequences. So there's no reset, but what you can do is store the configuration to a preset. I've already got some saved in here. So then you can reload, like this one, pigeons. Started out with 9-9-10. I can load a different thing. And then I can go back to that one and it's the same. So this is deterministic. It's not exactly random. It is an interesting sonification of math.
¶¶
the other side here, we have PolyDiv, which is a new trigger sequencer that I've implemented, basically copying the Subharmonicon step sequencer. There are four clock dividers that are all running simultaneously, and you can output them on either of the outputs. And so what you get is the logical OR operation of all these clock dividers. If you send a voltage to one of the CV inputs, that channel becomes an XOR combination of the selected clock dividers. This one, the whole thing is clocked by one input, and number two is reset. DivSeq, aka the division sequencer, is a sequence of clock dividers. So in this case, it executes the first step and then skips to, hold on, let me reset. And I'm gonna send a constant trigger sequence, ready? Each step, like for example, three means fire the first time and skip two. Again, there's one clock input and a reset.
I've also implemented these experimental performance mutes so you can quickly toggle each of the steps on and off. If you mute the first step, it still gets executed, so that enables an offset at the very start of the pattern.
Set the first step to 4, and then the subsequent ones to 8. Maybe mute these ones. And then that side would be a decent snare pattern. See? Pretty fun. And the thing is, so like 3 plus 2 plus 4 plus 1 is 10. So it's a total of a 10-step pattern, while the other side is an 8-step pattern.
Pretty cool for polyrhythms. If you send a positive voltage to one of the CV inputs, XOR means that it inverts the trigger pattern. So you end up with just the skipped clocks. Also, if you hold the voltage low, if you send a negative voltage, it will output the XOR of both patterns together. These new rhythm applets are great for drums.
Check this out. So we've got DivSeq. The snare is on the left. The right side is the kick pattern, just on a 4-4. And then PolyDiv we're using for hi-hats and claps. That's pretty cool. Toggle them on and off. And this is how we've got the clocks set up. The left applet is being clocked at X4, and the right applet's being clocked twice as fast. And they're each getting an automatic reset every 8 bars. We can turn on some swing.
Now, the cool thing about these kind of applets that we've collected here now is that there's trigger generators and there's pitch generators. And they've been designed in such a way that the trigger generators will automatically trigger a neighboring applet that generates pitches. This was originally copied from Benny Rose's probability divider and the probability melody generator. Probabilistic, stochastic melody generation, stochastic rhythm generation, and they were designed to talk to each other. So I've just kind of hijacked the same mechanism and made sure that this new PolyDiv sequencer will also trigger prob melody, and Pigeons generates pitches as well. So Pigeons can also get triggered by prob divider or PolyDiv or the DivSeq. So yeah, we've got a bunch of different ways to combine different methods of generating the rhythm, as well as different methods of generating the melodies. So there's a lot of fun, you know, fun world of sequencing available in the Ornament and Crime module now. I hope you enjoy. I'm about to add something to this, the clock divider. My idea is I'm going to add like a second clock divider to each channel. So it'll be a series of two of them.
I said I would, and I just upgraded this.
And once I've done that, then we'll have a way to have clock dividers in series with clock div. DivSeq gives you clock dividers in a sequence, and then PolyDiv gives you clock dividers in parallel. One last thing I wanted to demonstrate is the way that the presets work. A MIDI program change message will load the corresponding preset. So MIDI program change 0 loads preset A, MIDI PC 1 preset B, etc. And along with the new screen capture functionality that Paul from PJRC just implemented, you can do both. So you can sequence the entire module from your DAW while recording the screen on the same screen. And it's just like, it's really cool. So I've collected a few different configurations of trigger sequencer paired with melody sequencer, and I'm sequencing those presets with program change messages coming from the DAW in real time, and it works. Thanks for watching to the very end. All of my stolen code can be found freely on GitHub and probably elsewhere if other people have stolen it as well. Check for the GitHub link in the description where you can get it for the same price that I paid for it. And if you have anything left over and you like what I'm doing, why not buy me a coffee? Links in the description. Have fun. See you next time. Pew, pew, pew.